Today's session is on Jigsaw's strategy of cooperative learning. Jigsaw is one of the most popular and well-researched strategy of cooperative learning. We will be looking at is introduction, steps for Jigsaw strategy, advantages and limitations of Jigsaw strategy. At the end of the session, you will be able to explain steps of Jigsaw strategy, explain advantages and discuss limitations of Jigsaw strategy. Jigsaw, as the name suggests, involves some kind of puzzle making but in groups. Here there are two kinds of groups involved. One group is called as the home group and the other group is called as the expert group. The home group is the base group. From every home group, there are members identified who become the expert group. The expert group is assigned with the learning material which they need to master and ensure that the other members of the home group also learns them. Let's see how this happens. In Jigsaw strategy, every member of the home group is given a small content to be mastered. The individual member of the group masters the content and ensures that the other members also master the same content at a later stage. Let us see how this happens through this diagrammatic representation. Let us see the different steps of Jigsaw strategy. Initially, the teacher divides the entire class of students into groups of 5 or 6. This should correspond to the number of content that has to be mastered by the students. The groups should be diverse in terms of ability, gender, and race. These groups are called as the home groups. In the second step of Jigsaw strategy, the teacher appoints one student, preferably the most mature, from each group as the leader. Each member of the home group is asked to number themselves from 1 to 5. Now, students tagged as number 1 will sit together. Similarly, students tagged as number 2 from different groups will sit together. Now, these groups so formed are called as expert groups. Hence, it is seen that there is one student representative from every home group sitting in the expert group. In the next step, the teacher divides the topic into small subtopics based on the number of students per home group. That is, the teacher must ensure that the number of content or the subtopics corresponds to the number of students present in the home group. For instance, if you have 5 students in one home group and you want students to learn Maslow's hierarchy of needs, then you need to divide them as physiological, safety, belongingness, esteem, and self-actualization. In the step 4, each separate subtopic is assigned to each expert group to learn. That means group number 1 learns only about the physiological needs of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Group number 2 learns only about safety needs, and so on so forth. That means every member of the expert group has access only to the subtopic assigned to them. Through discussions in this group, every member ensures that they understand that subtopic thoroughly. In the step 5, the students are given time to read through their segment at least twice and become familiar with it. At this junction, the teacher can merge another cooperative learning strategy with Jigsaw strategy. For example, at step 5, the teacher can use think, pair and share strategy in order to ensure students mastering the given subtopic. At step 6, students in the expert groups are given time to discuss the main points of their topic, hence ensuring that the students rehearse and are thorough with what presentations they need to make in their home group. Here, every member of the expert group has the responsibility of ensuring the learning of every member of the home group. At step 7, the students come back to their home group from the expert group. At step 8, every student then presents his or her subtopic to the rest of the group. This encourages other students from the group to ask questions for clarification. At this junction, the individual doing the presentation can also refer back to the other members of the expert group for any further clarification. At step 9, students move from group to group observing the process. They intervene whenever and wherever required. For instance, if there is an argument or clarification is required, or if there is a conflict or dominance by a single student, intervention can be done in order to ease the tension in the group. The leader can be trained to handle such situations by whispering hints or clues till he or she gets a hang of it. At this step 10, which is the end of the session, a quiz is given on the material that has been mastered by the students. Students quickly come to realize that these sessions are not just fun and games, but really count. Here, there is positive interdependence that is clubbed into the entire process, where every member of the expert team is responsible for teaching other members of the group. Also, with the quiz on the material, one also ensures individual accountability. That means every member is responsible for his or her own learning as well as the learning of the entire group. There are several advantages of Jigsaw strategy. Jigsaw strategy encourages students to listen to each other. It encourages development of social skills. Also, in Jigsaw strategy, students function as a team. When students move from home group to expert group, they go with the responsibility of ensuring that the rest of the members are going to master or learn the topic that has been assigned to them. The Jigsaw strategy also has several limitations, such as the member who represents the home group in the expert group may not understand the topic, or at times might develop misconception or misunderstanding of the content, and the same could be conveyed to the other members of the group. At this junction, the teacher can be vigilant and can ensure that correct learning is happening in each and every group. At times, there could be a lack of participation on the part of the students. The students who represent the home group may not do the requisite learning in the expert group. This would mean that no learning happens with respect to that subtopic in the home groups too. So to sum up, Jigsaw strategy is an effective strategy of cooperative learning which can be used for effective student learning. Here, the students take up the role of the mentor and ensures not just his or her own learning, but also learning of the other groups. The home groups which are formed in Jigsaw strategy can remain even outside the activity in the classroom. Learning, mastering of a task can happen outside the classroom hours too. For this, the teacher needs to structure the Jigsaw strategy in a more detailed manner, and the same can be conveyed to the students. If the students are conveyed in the beginning about what is expected of them and the criteria for evaluation, this strategy can prove to be extremely effective, thus ensuring effective teaching-learning process.